Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. It's lovely to be back here at St. James's. First of all, I'd like to thank Julian Jacobson for inviting me to play today. But I can tell you, there's nothing quite like playing Beethoven for the Beethoven Society for putting the nerves right in you. I'm afraid I'm not too well, actually. I'm quite under the weather today, so I do apologize if I cough and splutter and sound a little bit nasally. I must tell you, the last time I played here, I think it was about 2 years ago, and I turned up about an hour before the concert and started rehearsing the Beethoven sonata that I had down in the program, so I thought, the Pathetique sonata, and about 5 minutes before coming on to play, somebody told me that in fact I'd put the Moonlight Sonata down. I then asked the audience, in a bit of a panic, whether they'd rather me stick with the piece that I'd prepared, or if they would prefer an off-the-cuff Moonlight Sonata, because inevitably, of course, a number of people had come especially to hear that piece. And thank goodness, by only a few hands, they chose the Pathetique. I must have been out of my tiny mind, but it's lovely to come back and actually play the sonata that I programmed in the first place. So, on to some less known music now, which tends really to be my speciality, I suppose. I've chosen four nocturnes by a wonderful Irish composer and great pianist, great contemporary of Chopin, called John Field. Not too many people are aware that, in fact, Field invented the nocturne, the idea of a miniature nighttime piece, if you like, a dreamlike reverie. He wrote 18 of them all together, and I'm delighted to say that in a couple of months' time, I shall be recording them all, along with the sonatas, in fact, on two CDs for Brilliant Classics. I'm still very much at the beginning of this project, in fact, so much so that only a couple of days ago, I was still struggling to memorize one or two of these pieces. So the four I've chosen, the first one is Liszt's favorite of the entire collection. It's the second one in C minor. Liszt described it as being like a late night moonlit walk, noticing the shadows of birch trees. Very melancholic and stirring piece. The second one is probably my favorite one, in fact, which is perhaps a little bit more pastoral in nature. Maybe hints at Irish folk song, perhaps. The third one is Schumann's favorite of the collection, and maybe represents more of an operatic aria, I think, in places. And the last one, the E-flat one, is more of a lullaby, I think. So even though all four pieces are relatively similar in style, there are slight differences in, I think, what John Field was trying to get at. So, four nocturnes by John Field.
Thank you.
absolute gems, aren't they? Well, in some respects, from the sublime to the cool blimey now. I'm certainly going to give this piano a good workout with the grossest concert solo of Liszt, probably the blandest title he ever thought of, I'm sure. He was usually very poetical, but he couldn't think of anything other than big concert work, big concert solo. But it certainly is what it says on the tin. There's no two ways about that. Just as a show of hands, out of curiosity, does anybody know this piece? Has anybody heard it before? A handful. It's not very well known, but it's a particularly important piece within Liszt's output because it directly precedes the piano sonata, the great B minor sonata, which is probably the finest of all of his piano works. And you can tell that he was already thinking, particularly structurally, of something along the lines of a single movement sonata in this work. It's not a sonata, and Liszt knew that it wasn't a sonata, but he also knew that it wasn't a fantasy either. So neither a sonata or a fantasy, big concert solo. There you go. Some of the themes are in fact rather similar. There's a theme in this concert solo that goes, famously in the sonata, they're somewhere fairly close, I think. So, this is the grossest concert solo, and I'll see you on the other side of it.
Thank you.
That clock is always a reminder that I am quickly becoming the Ken Dodd of classical music. I do like to overrun. I never get my timings right with programs, and never ever do. Well, it's a rare and lovely honor to have one of my dearest friends in the audience, John, who's been, I think, taking a few photos at the back. He's just given me a wave. And I thought it would be a nice tribute to say thanks for everything you do for me, to play one of our favorite of Mendelssohn's Songs Without Words. Thank you.